Alright guys, I'm back for more Bayonetta 2.
This is... Welcome to hell, love. Too late to repent. These are the gates. Whatever your friend did to get on the other side of these, let's just say she's not having a good day.
No, she isn't, little one. But she'd still be alive if she hadn't wasted her life saving mine.
Huh? Well, she doesn't seem like such a bad friend after all. Fimbulventa can wait for now. I'm opening the gate.
Well, thank you.
Oh, I can't just leave you at a shuttered gate after your sob story, love. Besides, who's gonna save you if our stalker decides to show up again? All right, let's do this. Try to keep up.
What's that, guys?
Aren't we in a hurry?
That's like really unfortunate for the lighting model or lighting engine. So essentially we have him now instead of those stupid outclasses from the first game. That's what that blue bar is. Okay, it's his health bar. I didn't know that in some fights, he fights alongside you. I thought you were just solo for the majority of these fights.
Try to keep up.
You handle this.
No. What? A golem. Jesus, did they take inspiration from this boss for a boss in Kingdom Hearts 3? Holy shit. I'm in serious Kingdom Hearts 3 flashbacks.
To open it.
Just seeing if there's anything else real quick.
Let's try out this piece.
Automatically, and for some reason, because it does it automatically when I tap things sometimes, it transforms into an animal when I don't want to be. Capitalism. Thank you.
sitting around.
Progress.
Try to keep up. Hey, wait!
Try to keep up turns into a fucking sprite and goes inside Bayonetta because he can't go underwater for some reason. Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
One thing I do like about this game is, it rewards your curiosity if you explore a little bit in areas. Yeah, that's one of the things I actually kind of like about this game is that, or I actually very much appreciate in this game is that you can explore a little bit and they reward your sense of curiosity. I appreciate that. There are so many games where you can just explore the areas you're in and... shit. Well... proven wrong.
Right there.
Get out of our way. Fucking Christ, the bosses in this level, I feel like they inspired a boss in Kingdom Hearts 3. Really fucking weird. I would not be surprised if Tootsie and Amora played this game at some point. This game seems right up his alley. God, if Tootsie and Amora and Hideki Kamiya made a game, that would be insane. Oh yeah, how do you guys, prefer, like, bosses in games? Just, like, unpredictable or predictable enough? Yeah, that's what I meant by predictable. Yeah. Because, I mean, like, the reason I say that is because Kingdom Hearts is both, depending on the game, or just either or, and they suck every time that they're unpredictable. Or they have no set pattern. On top of that, they have fucking super armor. Which I fucking hate super armor in video games. At the very least, you can't, like, really counteract it.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, I like that sometimes in games where the devs definitely didn't intend on you having certain things within cutscenes. And funny shit happens because of that. Mm-hmm.
Time to do business. What's your pleasure?
Basically. Alright guys, I'm gonna pause here and continue in the next one.